Gavin Hayes is a research geophysicist for the United States Geological Survey. Gavin joins us now. Gavin, what can you tell us about the strength and location of this quake? Just looking at the pictures, it seems like a 6.2, not that strong, and yet the damage is extensive.
Yeah, the damage is extensive, Tony, just because of how close the earthquake is to the surface. When you have an earthquake of this size, very close to the surface, you get high-intensity shaking, severe shaking felt over a broad area. And in a place like this, where the buildings are vulnerable to this type of shaking, they fall down, and that heavy brick masonry traps people underneath the rubble.
And Professor Hayes, the earthquake, was it a surprise to people in this region, or is this region known for earthquakes already?
This region has a history of earthquakes of this size. In 1997, just to the north, there was a similarly sized event that caused a large sequence of aftershocks and damaged the town of Assisi. Just to the south in 2009, there was a magnitude 6.3 earthquake and a lot of aftershocks near the town of L'Aquila. So the region has experienced earthquakes of this type before.
Now, that region has a lot of old buildings, historic buildings. There's not so much changing you can do to those. So how can they really prepare, given their likelihood of future earthquakes in this same location?
It's very tough when you live in old buildings. Modern seismic codes improve buildings that we're constructing now. The best way to make old buildings safe is to retrofit them. But as you say, that's very difficult with some old buildings.
Something else that's very difficult, but that I imagine you are asked about a lot of cocktail parties, is whether or not someday, in the not-too-distant future, we will be able to predict earthquakes, give people some kind of warning. Is that possible?
I personally don't feel that earthquake prediction is close. Earthquakes are just too much of a random process to be able to get close to prediction. What we can do is help forecast the likelihood of future events based on what we've observed historically, and do things like earthquake early warning, where we can observe the very first arriving energy of earthquakes that doesn't cause a lot of shaking, to give people seconds to minutes of warning, depending on how far away that earthquake is, that heavy shaking might be about to arrive.
All right, Gavin Hayes, research geophysicist at the U.S. Geological Survey. Thank you very much for joining us.
My pleasure.